Welcome to online classes DGO Nalgonda. Today we will discuss about quadrilaterals. In this we go through one theorem. The line segment joining the midpoints of two sides in a triangle is parallel to third side and also half of it. That theorem is called as the midpoint theorem. Let's go through it. We will draw a triangle. We will name it as ABC. In this you have to take the midpoints and we have to join. The midpoints are D and E. We will write the given. In the question itself it is given as D is the midpoint of AB, E is the midpoint of AC. Then what does it mean? AD is equal to DB and AE is equal to EC. What we have to prove? Parallel to third side and also half of it. The side DE is parallel to BC. This we have to prove, and as well as DE is half of BC. To prove this, we need some construction. We have to draw a line parallel to AB through C. That line name is, I would like to take it as CF. Draw CF parallel to AB. I will denote the line with the dots up to F and produce DE to F. Like this. Now we get one more triangle there, its name is triangle CEF. Proof. Select the two triangles AED and CEF. In these two triangles, what are equal? That we have to write. AE is equal to EC and angle AED is equal to angle CEF. How can I say that both the angles are equal? Since they are vertically opposite angles. And we need one more side or one more angle. Shall I write DF is the transversal? Shall I write that? Yes. How? AB and CF, these two are lines intersected by DF. That's why DF is a transversal. In this, I would like to write these two angles are equal. Angle ADE is equal to angle CFE. How can I say the both the angles are equal? The two angles are, just observe, on the either side of the transversal and both the angles are in the interior. Just observe this, these two angles. It is A, D, B, this is F, C. Alternate interior angles. So, here we have two angles and one side. By ASA property, the two triangles are congruent. Triangle AED is congruent to triangle CEF. Then we can write the corresponding parts are equal. The corresponding parts are, shall I write AD is equal to CF? Yes, and DE is equal to EF. Let us take BCFD is a quadrilateral. In this quadrilateral, BD parallel CF. How? This is from construction. And I would like to write BD is equal to CF. Since AD is equal to DB and DB is equal to CF. That's it. AD is equal to DB, AD is equal to DB and AD is equal to CF. Here BCFD is a parallelogram. How can I write this as a parallelogram? In the parallelogram, one pair of opposite sides are parallel and equal. So here BD parallel to CF and as well as BD is equal to CF. That's why BCFD is a parallelogram. And if it is a parallelogram, then opposite sides are parallel and equal. The remaining opposite sides are BF and CB, the both the sides are equal. So I would like to write BF parallel to BC. This implies BF, for DF, DF parallel to BC and DE is the part of DF. That's why it implies DE parallel BC and DF is equal to BC. DF is double of DE. How can I write that? Because DE is equal to EF. That's why this DF is equal to, I can write as 2DE. So here I would write it right, 2DE is equal to BC. So DE is equal to half BC. Like this, we have to prove. Let us go through the converse of the previous theorem. Just observe. It is a triangle ABC. In this triangle, we have to take the midpoint of one side. D is the midpoint of AB. And we have to draw a line through this midpoint. And that line will be parallel to the second side, like this. Suppose it is DF parallel to BC and D is the midpoint, bisects the third side. This we have to prove. So DF bisects AC, that means F is the midpoint of AC. This is the converse of the midpoint theorem, that you have to prove. That is the work for you. And we will go through one more question. We will observe example 9. This is the triangle ABC. In this triangle, D is the midpoint of BC. And we have to take one more point, that is E. This is the midpoint of AC. That means AD is the median and BE is the median. And these two are medians. I will write AD comma BE are medians. And I have drawn one more line, that is DF, and I have given DF is parallel to BE. We have to prove that CF is equal to 1/4 of AC. This we have to prove. Solution. Let us take the triangle BEC. Draw the figure of triangle BEC. D is the midpoint. F. Just observe. Now itself we have discussed the converse of the midpoint theorem. In a triangle, the line joining the midpoint of one side and parallel to the second side bisects the third side. From that we can write that DF is half of BE. And we can write F is the midpoint of CE, since converse of midpoint theorem. So, F is the midpoint in the sense EF is equal to FC. We have known that E is the midpoint of AC. That means AE is equal to EC. We can write EC as EF plus FC. This is CF plus FC is written as, sorry, EF. EF is written as FC. Shall I write that? AE is equal to 2CF or 2FC. AE is half of AC. So, I will replace this AE with half AC. AC is equal to 4CF, because when 2 comes to its this side, it will multiply. So, CF is equal to 1/4 of AC. Like this we have to prove. Let us go through one more example. This is triangle ABC. In this triangle, find the midpoints of each of the sides and join the 3 midpoints, we will get one triangle. We have to prove that the triangle formed by joining the midpoints of the sides of a triangle the perimeter of triangle DEF is equal to half of the perimeter of triangle ABC. This we have to prove. To prove that, we have to recall all the theorems which you have learnt so far. Here DE is the line segment joined by the midpoints. So, this DE is parallel to BC from the midpoint theorem and also half of it. So, DE is equal to, I can write, half BC. The same EF is also the segment joined by the midpoint. That is why EF is parallel to AB and EF is equal to half AB. The same applicable for the third side DF. We will join these three, DE plus EF plus DF is equal to half BC plus half AB plus half AC. So, we have to take out half common. When half comes outside, in the bracket we have BC plus AB plus AC, and this side DE plus EF plus DF. What is this DE plus EF plus DF? That is the perimeter of triangle DEF. perimeter of triangle DEF is equal to half the perimeter of triangle ABC. Like this you have to prove. And for you the homework, I will give example 7. That is, it is a triangle ABC. Take the midpoints, join them and name it as DEF. You have to prove that these all four the triangles are congruent to each other. That is the work for you. And also exercise 8.4 is the homework. Let us take one brain teaser question. See the first one. This is a figure. By drawing two lines on this figure, we have to form 10 triangles. Just try it. And the second one, we have one rectangle and as well as a square. These two figures are having the same area, but we have to cut this triangle into two pieces, not equal pieces. You have to cut them into two pieces, and by joining the two pieces, we have to form a square. Suppose these are the measurements of the rectangle. I would like to cut this figure horizontally. Suppose if it is 5, and then definitely it will become 4. By joining these two, I have to get a square. That is the task for you. To do this, I will give one hint. Take a rectangular paper and measure them with 16 × 9. The length will be 16 centimeters and the breadth should have 9 centimeters. So cut them into two pieces, join them, and you have to form a square. So it is a practical question that you have to do at home. Thank you.